This is Janice.
Hi, Janice. How are you doing?
Good. Hey.
Good to see you.
Janice, yes. Yeah. She comes here every day. Uh-huh. Upstairs in the day program. Right, Janice?
You work upstairs?
You work, right?
Today. Yeah, well, there's a lot of stuff going on.
It is, yes.
I really wanted to have an opportunity to chat with you a little bit. As you know, investing in seniors, and particularly supporting Canadians with dementia, and
yes.
The community that support them is one of the big things that we've done in this budget.
Yes.
And I really want to sort of hear from you about what this great center provides for you in terms of support and help, and how we can continue to help.
Oh, well, it was a great time when we found this place. We were going through some hard time, and it was very difficult, actually, to find places where we can bring Janice, and especially because, like, I work full-time, and to have that extended care as well during the day, not just, 9 to 3 or whatever, we're able to bring her in, if I have to, 8 to 5, come every day for the day program and on Saturdays. And also for, we have the transitional care unit, which we use it for some respite time. If I have some meetings I have to go to, or operations I've had in the past, that I'm able, there's some place where I can bring her. And we have PSWs also on a full-time that I'm able to provide to her through the center. And we also have our primary doctors here as well. So we use the whole facility on a daily basis. Right, Janice?
And how has, I mean, obviously you've been supportive and caregiving for your sister for a long time.
Yes.
How has Alzheimer's come and made things more complicated? Obviously, that's an extra layer of challenge.
It's been about 6-7 years now, that the progression. And it's quite difficult at times, but we have very good days, and then we have not so good days, but those days, we just, just keep moving forward. I love her. And, it's just what you do.
Yeah.
And we also have another sister at home,
mm-hmm.
with special needs as well. And we all live together, right? Yeah. Oh, yeah. No, it's been wonderful being able to, leave her. And I know that, she's well taken care of. They have good programs here to enrich her life every day.
I mean, it's a reality that increasing numbers of Canadians are being affected by dementia. So putting forward the first national strategy on dementia with $50 million over the next 5 years is about research, it's about better guidelines, and it's about supporting the extraordinary families who do
such a
great job.
Thank you very much.
Really, really appreciate the opportunity to sit down with you.
Same with me. Thank you.
Great.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Say hi. Thank you.
You're
gonna take his hand?
Fist bump.
Fist bump.
There
we go.
There you go. We got a smile.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah,
we gotta
go
to work.
You're gonna have to go to work upstairs.
That's right.
That's
there's
smile. The smile.
All
right.
Good girl. But thank you so much.
Thank you.
So much.
Thank you.
Say thank you.
That's right.
That's right.
Better quality of
life.
That's right.
It's less about the cost of society.
That's right.
And how business you're calling.
That's right, because it's closer to home as well, and that's where they want to care.
Displacement.
That's right.
When you're starting to have to face a lot of
Career challenges.
Yeah. 100%. So it's great to have everything in one building, because then they can access primary care on the second floor, they can access the adult services program on the second floor as well, and it's really.
How many employees?
For almost 2 years. It's a really great place to work, a really hard place to be, destined.
Federal government isn't the primary funding that the province is, but we are glad to see.
Thank you so much for having me. We really appreciate it.
Thank you.
I love it, it's great.
Yeah, I was going to say, do you live in Scarborough?
Minutes, drive, 18 minutes by.
We're getting more into that weather. We're all excited.
Did you get more people in the weather? What did you go to?
So I went to York University and I did health and society. And then I started reading a grant for research. It's just been a wonderful experience working with families that are learning about, learning about that and also just working with seniors.
Talk about some of the examples of what you would call recreational therapy. Taking sort of daily activities, whether they're social or physical activities or whatever, and thinking about how you can use those to enhance and enrich
lives in multiple ways. Right. So in terms of integration. Come on over. So how are you guys doing? What are you, what are your various responsibilities here? What are you doing?
And the shortage of labor, so like the frontline staff is